Hello everyone, today let's see how to handle basic HTTP authentication in Playwright. In Playwright, you can handle basic HTTP authentication pop-up using multiple ways, few of them we will discuss today. So for demo, you can visit theinternetherokuapp.com/basicauth. So here you will see basic HTTP authentication pop-up and username is admin, password is same admin, and after entering username and password and clicking on sign in, you will see basic auth heading. So let's verify it, that after handling pop-up we can see this heading basic auth. So the simplest way is by entering username password in the URL. So await page.goto, then copy your URL, paste it here and add your username, then password after the colon and then add the rate. So this is the simplest way. You might have used it in Selenium as well. Now after handling the pop-up, we can expect that the heading to have text basic auth. So inspect it to get the selector. So div with class example, then we have a heading. So div dot class example and then greater than sign h3. So this is unique, copy it. So we can verify heading is heading to have a text basic auth. Now let's execute it. So it handled the authentication pop-up. Now it's looking for a basic auth heading and it verified it. So this is the simplest way. You can keep this URL in your config file as well. So cut it from here and inside use base URL and base URL value. And here in page.goto, keep it blank. If you will add single forward slash, what it will do, it will visit the home page of Heroku app and you will not see the basic auth. You can see we are not on basic auth page, we are on the internet.herokuapp.com with home page. So and our test will fail. So keep it as blank so that it uses your this URL which is in config file. So now you can see it is on basic auth and it verified the heading. Now another way of doing this is using the Playwright way at test case level, but problem with this approach is it's not at global level. This is to handle a specific test case level case. So use here browser instead of page. Now create browser context variable give it name context equal to await browser dot new context now here use curly brackets then pass in HTTP credentials as an option now inside HTTP credentials give your username which is admin and your password which is also admin now after creating this context instance create your page instance using context instance now we have created our page instance now using your page instance you can visit your URL and you can verify your basic auth heading now let's see if it is working so it visited and handled the authentication popup and we have verified basic auth heading now if your authentication popup is on home page you can just add forward slash no need to keep it as blank now earlier we had a method called set HTTP credentials which is deprecated now so after creating context variable you can use await context.set HTTP credentials so here you can see it's deprecated so in round bracket you can give username admin and password admin it's a string so this method will work for some time but it's outdated you can verify now this method we discussed just now for handling the authentication is good for one test case however usually we need to handle it for all test cases unless there is a special case so in that case we can set up this authentication at configuration level so here keep page only no need to use browser and copy this HTTP credentials username and password go to your config file paste it inside use json add comma here now that's the only thing you need to do after that just visit your URL await page.goto and verify your heading so this is the preferred way of doing the things keep it at config level let's see if it is working Now it's looking for a basic auth. This is the best approach for our project to keep it at config level and then your URL. No need to add this admin. That's all. Thank you for watching this video.